Hello everyone, welcome back. In today's video, I will show you guys how to update ESP8266 Wi-Fi modules firmware to the latest available AT command firmware from the Espress website. I purchased the ESP8266 Wi-Fi module to use it in one of my projects, but then I found that the current firmware which is present inside this module is very old, and that's why I decided to update it with the new one. So in this video I will share all the important steps with you guys, so that in future if you want to update the firmware of your Wi-Fi module, you can do it easily. So to update the firmware, you need a USB to UART converter and few cables or mechanical switches to connect the reset pin and flash pin of the module to the ground pin. This is my USB to TTL converter for my ESP8266 Wi-Fi module, and this is my ESP8266 Wi-Fi module. I can connect my module directly with my USB to UART converter like this. And on the bottom side, I have taken out two wires from the ground pin of this module, and this blue cable is connected to the reset of the ESP8266 module, and this brown cable is connected to the flash pin of the ESP8266 module. Instead of these male to female cables, you can also use mechanical switches. I didn't have at this time, so I'm using these cables. So when we wanted to program the module, we have to connect the flash pin and the reset pin with the ground pin. And when we start our programming process, we have to disconnect the reset pin from the ground pin as shown here. And I will show you when we have to do this step. So before proceeding further, make sure your module is connected to USB port and old firmware is also working. You can check this with any serial terminal tool utility. In my case, I prefer using HW Hercules tool. And I am sending AT commands and the module is responding with OK message. This confirms that my Wi-Fi module is working fine. Now coming to the tools required. First, we will download the flash tool from the Espress If website download section. Links are given in the description section also. And then we will download the latest AT firmware from the same section, which is version 1.7.4 at this time. After downloading, extract both the folders and then start the flash download tool as administrator. Click on the developer mode, then click on the ESP8266 download tool. Make sure all these checkboxes are unchecked and SPI download tab is selected. This is very important step. First, we have to determine which flash is present on our module. Select the correct COM port and set the baud rate as 115200 and connect the reset pin and flash pin of the module to ground pin. Now, I will press the start button. Now you will see some dashes on the command prompt screen. After a few seconds, I disconnected the reset line from the ground pin, and now this download tool will detect some information from the module, which is crystal frequency, which is 26 MHz in my case, the flash size, which is 8 megabit in my case, and it also detected the MAC address in station mode and the access point modes. This all information is very important, especially the flash size information. Now we will open the Espress If AT documentation PDF file, links are given in the description, and search for the section downloading AT firmware into the flash. Since the module which I have is having 8 megabit flash, I will open that section of documentation. Depending on what you get from the tool, you will open that particular relevant section according to your device. And now we can see certain addresses here, and we will put these addresses in the flash download tool with the corresponding binaries. Make sure you check all the checkboxes this time. Once this is done, make sure your reset pin and flash pins are connected to ground once again, and now you have to follow the same process again. Press the start button. Once you start getting some dots and dashes, disconnect the reset line from the ground, and now here comes the magic. Your firmware is getting uploaded. Once the firmware is uploaded, you can disconnect the reset and flash pin from the ground and reconnect your module to the USB port to check if this is working or not. As you can see, this is working in my case. I used two commands to verify. One is 80 and another one is the version number. So you can see the version number from the module 80 command is matching the version which I programmed. So in future, I will be using this ESP826655 module for some of my projects. I hope you like this video. In case you have some doubt, please feel free to contact me. If you want me to make some other type of videos, please let me know in the comment section. Thank you guys. Thanks for watching.